we can get a much better sense for what the integral's actually computing by converting the integral into a function.
So the way that I'm going to package together a whole bunch of integrals is into a function, the accumulation function. What is this accumulation function going to do? Well, here I've graphed y equals f of t on the ty plane. And I picked a fixed point A, and then I imagine I've got another point that I can vary that I've labeled x. And the accumulation function is the integral from A to x. So it computes the area between A and x under the graph of this function. And it's called the accumulation function because I imagine that as I move x to the side, I'm kind of accumulating more and more area. I'm determining how much area I've accumulated between A and whatever I plug into the accumulation function.
When is this accumulation function increasing?
As long as this function little f is positive, the accumulation function is increasing. Look, to determine whether the function's increasing, I just have to plug in bigger inputs and see if I get bigger outputs. That's what increasing means. So if I were to plug in some bigger input, right, the accumulation function just figures out how much area is between A and this bigger input. And as long as my function's positive, there's now more area between A and this bigger input than there was between A and X. So I can summarize this as saying that F is positive, and that makes my accumulation function increasing.
When is this accumulation function decreasing? Is it ever possible to integrate over a longer interval and yet get a smaller value?
Yes, it sounds counterintuitive, but that's entirely possible. And it really comes down to this issue about what these integrals are really measuring. The integrals are not exactly measuring area, they're measuring signed area. So here's an example where the function that I'm graphing, y equals f of t, passes below the, what I'm calling here the t-axis. And when the graph is below and I'm calculating the integral, this area here counts as negative in the integral. So this area, which is above the axis here, is calculated as honest area. But this area here is really contributing negative area to the integral, right? I mean, I'm taking this area and I'm subtracting this area to figure out the integral from A to X. And it comes down to how this integral is defined. The integral is defined as a Riemann sum. It's the function's value evaluated at various sample points times the widths of those tiny rectangles. And if I'm evaluating the function and the function's value is negative, then that's not really an area. That's a signed area, and it could be negative. All right, well, in light of that, what happens in this particular case, right? What happens if I plug in a bigger input to my accumulation function? Is it possible that I could integrate over a longer interval and yet get a smaller value? And yeah, this is an exact picture of the sort of situation where that happens. If I plug in a bigger input here, then when I integrate from A to this bigger input, I'm not only subtracting this red negative area, I'm subtracting this larger red negative area. And in that case, my accumulation function really is smaller, right? As I take x and drag it over here, I'm gathering up more negative area, and so my accumulation function is going down. And I'll summarize that like this. If the function's negative, the accumulation function is decreasing.
What does this sound like?
Well, what that sounds like is that the derivative of the accumulation function is related to the thing I'm integrating, the so-called integrand. Right? If I'm integrating a positive function, the accumulation function is increasing. And another way to say that the accumulation function is increasing would be to say that the derivative is positive. So integrand's positive, derivative of accumulation function is positive. The function that I'm integrating is negative, the accumulation function is decreasing. The derivative of the accumulation function is negative. Integrand negative, derivative of accumulation function also negative.
This is our first hint at the fundamental theorem of calculus, some sort of relationship between derivatives and integrals.